One thing that we have to understand about the hour that we're in, this is the consummation of time. It's the last days. The Bible says that in these days, the Bible says in Matthew 24 and 12 that iniquity shall abound. Is that right? And he said the love of many will wax cold. But it doesn't just start there, neither does it stop there. He said that there should be famines in the lands, there should be wars, there should be rumors of wars, there should be a pestilence and all kinds of stuff happening. And one thing that we have to do with the people of God is make sure that we don't become reactive to the things that are going on in the world. We have to always remain ready. God is telling us right now that if my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray, if they shall seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, he says, then I'll hear from heaven, I'll forgive their sin, and then I will heal their land. Want to wash our hands, but you should have been washing your hands. Now all of a sudden we want to take more baths. Man, you should have been taking a bath. I went to Walmart and I looked on the shelf and all the soap was gone, and the first thing that I thought about is, man, what they've been bathing with this whole time. Why is it now that all the soap is gone? You can't find soap nowhere. So you mean to tell me all these years, what, y'all been bathing with water or something? Where'd all the soap go? But see, now what we're doing now is that we are changing the way that we live, and it's becoming something of convenience, but it's not a lifestyle. God wants this thing to be a lifestyle. I can feel the Holy Ghost now. He wants this thing to be a lifestyle. He said, you can't just live right now just because there's a disease in the air. He said, God, I want to live right now. Oh, God, I'm coming to church now. But then as soon as this thing subsides, that's when your testing season is going to come. That's when your testing season is about to come. That's when he wants to see, do you love me more than this? Do you want me more than this? Or was this something that was temporary just because a calamity was upon the earth? Does he have to keep putting you in trials and tribulations, in dangers seen, in dangers unseen? Is this something he has to do continuously? Or can he stand up and say, I trust my daughter. She done been through the fire. She done been through the storm. And she still came out. And still came out giving me praise. She went through giving me praise. She came out giving me praise. And when I delivered her, she still has her hands lifted. And she's still saying, Father, I love you more than this. Father, I love you more than a man. I love you more than a boyfriend. I love you more than a girlfriend. I love you more than the weed. I love you more than the cigarettes. I love you more than for me being a freebase and whore chaser, whiskey nipping, cocaine snipping, weed chopping, pill popping, tobacco chewing, cigarette sucking, pipe puffing devil. I don't want to live like that no more. But I'm going to put away the filthiness of the flesh, and now it's time to say bye-bye to the world and hello Jesus. He's right there. The Bible says if you come nigh unto him, that he'll come nigh unto you. But he's waiting on you to make the decision to come nigh unto him, because as soon as you do that, his hand is not too heavy, that his arm is not too short, that he cannot deliver. His ear is not too heavy, that he cannot hear your cry. He's waiting on you to cry. He's waiting on you to say, Lord, I want you more than this. Lord, say, save me. Lord, deliver me. I know I done messed up time after time. I done played with homosexuality and I don't want to do it no more. I done played with cigarettes and I don't want to do it no more. I done played with fornication. I done lied. I done backed up on you. I done backslid. But Father, if you take me like I am, I hear you'll clean you up. If you take me like I am, I promise you, I'll make a decision and I'll follow on to know you. Not just staying where I am, but going on to see what the end is gonna be. If you believe that, shout hallelujah.